Nos están llevando al diablo.
I thought by what we are doing, many are even coming to shop in your store.
Y lo que estamos haciendo aquí,
that the members of my church are even coming to shop in your store.
Y que vienen más a la church con nosotros.
I was here before all of you came.
Hemos estado aquí.
I am the one who gave easement
antes que todo
for some of the stores to be built.
Para que hicieran todo lo que
it is on my parking lot that the equipment that were used to build your store was put on my parking lot.
En este apartamento, en el parqueado.
And I was preaching when even this place was empty. I was preaching on top of my voice.
Y estábamos predicando cuando
and,
no había
and now as soon as you come in, you say, because you hate the word of God, you say, I am driving away your customers.
Y ahora porque estamos predicando.
Which is important, the word of God, the souls of the people, or the things, the money that you are going to make. Money takes wings and flies.
Y no quieren escuchar el nombre de Dios y la maldición del dinero. Eso es lo que quieren hacer.
The Bible says the heart of man is desperately wicked.
La Biblia dice que el corazón del hombre es desesperadamente
and full of ingratitude and ungratefulness.
Con ingratitud y todo lo que no están haciendo.
The same person who was telling me this,
la misma persona que nos decían,
wouldn't have any problem.
No tuvieran problema.
If Snoopy Doggy Doggy and all those kind of people come on this parking lot
y los tuplantes vienen aquí
and set their stage.
Y están diciendo,
and they are playing those their perverted music. They will abandon even their work and come and be doing dancing like crocodile out of water.
Y música de cocodrilo que no están gustando.
And yet when the gospel is being preached,
pero aún cuando estamos predicando el gospel de,
you become offended.
Se ofenden por lo que
and you feel like the gospel is driving away your customers.
Y por eso dicen que los
wait until hell opens its mouth.
Espera que el diablo venga.
And they will say, have we known?
Y van a decir, si
we should have listened to Pastor Pimpong.
Si
we should have listened to Reverend Pimpong. Because the battle for your soul
la maldición de
is being waged between two.
Está malgastando lo que es malo que está.
Hell
el infierno
is seeking for your soul.
Está buscando tu maldición.
Heaven
el cielo
also seeks for your soul.
Está buscando tu salvación.
But one is very aggressive.
Pero cuando hay una persona,
and that is hell.
Y en la maldición,
Satan is very aggressive.
Satan te espera.
Because he knows his time is short.
Porque él sabe que el tiempo
and because his time is short.
Porque el tiempo es perdido,
he wants to drag as many as he can into that kingdom.
Quiere llevar muchos y
that
muchos.
Is why I am here tonight. That is why we are here tonight, to let you know that there is a man whose name is Jesus Christ. He said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. Jesus Christ loves your soul. Jesus Christ has a better place for you. Jesus Christ offers you the true life. Satan does not like you.
Satan
doesn't love you. Satan came to steal, kill, and to destroy you. He will make you have your drug. He will allow you to fornicate. He will allow you to have all those sexually perverted lifestyles. And you will die and go to be with him in hell. But tonight, Jesus Christ says, come unto me. Come unto me. Come unto me. Bring your burdens. Bring your sins. Bring your iniquities. Bring them, for I died for you. I am willing to forgive.
Te va a perdonar.
I am willing to wash you.
Te va a lavar.
I am willing to cleanse you.
Te va a limpiar.
I am willing to save you.
Te va a salvar.
I am willing to restore you.
Te va a restaurar.
Into a place of peace.
En la parte de
paz. And of comfort.
Y confortarte.
Would you give your life to Jesus Christ tonight?
Date la vida a Jesucristo.
City of Greensboro. Will you give your life to Jesus Christ tonight? County of Guilford, Will you give your life to Jesus Christ tonight? State of North Carolina, will you give your life to Jesus Christ tonight? Nation of America, will you give your life to Jesus Christ tonight? The nations of the whole world, will you give your life to Jesus Christ tonight? There is no hope in any man. There is no hope in any politician. Don't let any one of them deceive you. None of them has any hope for you. They have no hope to offer you. It is only Jesus Christ and Him crucified.
Ninguno de ellos tiene la salvación de salvarte.
Politicians will tell you all that they want to tell you.
Los políticos te dicen lo que ellos quieren saber.
Their eyes are on the money that they make for themselves.
Los ojos están en la maldad.
But Jesus Christ,
pero Jesucristo,
offers Himself unto you and will give you life.
Y te da
He will give you joy. When you are backed up in the corner, Jesus Christ will stand with you.
Jesucristo vendrá.
Don't put your trust in any man.
No ponga la fe en
put God. Your trust in Jesus.
Ponga la fe en Jesucristo.
Put your confidence in Jesus
ponga
Christ.
La esperanza en Jesucristo.
Put your hope in Jesus Christ.
La esperanza en Jesucristo.
He will give you peace.
Te va a dar paz.
Eternal peace.
Eternidad.
Everlasting peace.
Y balance.
Put your trust in Jesus Christ.
Ponga la fe en Jesucristo.
Put your trust and your confidence in Jesus.
Pon la fe y la confianza.
For He is the only one.
Es el único.
Who can wash away your sins.
Que puede lavarte la
and make you whole.
Y hacerte bueno.
Would you receive Him tonight?
Recíbelo hoy.
In a moment I'm going to ask you.
Esta noche te vamos a
you may be walking on the parking lot.
Puedes estar caminando.
You may be sitting in your car listening to the word of God.
Tal vez estás en tu casa.
I thank you so much for lending your ears to the word of God.
Gracias por estar escuchando.
It tells that you really love God and fear Him.
Es la seriedad que
and so there is hope for you.
Él te va a venir.
In as much as you have not rejected the word of God tonight.
En lo más que no ha reservado.
Know that the Lord Himself has a plan for you.
Sepa que Dios tiene un
plan. But I'm going to ask you to do something tonight.
Te pedimos que hagas
that
algo.
You may not have done it before.
Que nunca has hecho.
If you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior,
si no sabes a Jesucristo,
would you please come out of your car wherever you are?
Ven a tu carro y ven a
and stand with us as we lift up our hearts unto heaven.
Y párese con nosotros.
And cry unto God and say, Lord Jesus Christ,
y rezar con nosotros.
Have mercy upon me.
Ten.
Forgive me for my sins.
Perdón por nuestros pecados.
Cleanse me and make me whole.
Límpianos y hacernos limpios.
Jesus Christ is calling you tonight.
Jesucristo te llama esta noche.
Would you come?
Ven por favor.
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 Shall we all rise unto our feet?
Levantemos a rezar.
Someday you will stand on the bar, run high. Someday your records you will see. Someday you will answer the question of life. What will your answer be? What will it be? Oh, what would it be? Where would you spend your eternity? What would it be? Oh, what would it be? What would your answer be? Sadly, you will stand if you are unprepared, trembling. You will fall on your knees, facing the sentence of life or of death. What will that sentence be? What will you be? Oh, what would it be? Where would you spend your eternity? What would it be? Oh, what would it be? What will your answer be? Now is the time to prepare, my friend. Make your soul spotless and free. Wash in the blood of the crucified one. He will your answer be. Oh, what would it be, Greensboro? What would it be, Guilford County? Where would you spend your eternity? What would it be, North Carolina? What would it be, America? What will your answer be? Oh, what would it be? Oh, what would it be? What would your answer be? Oh, sing it with me. What would it be? Oh, what would it be? What would your answer be? Let's pray. Say this after me. Lord Jesus Christ, I have heard your word and I have believed your word. I realize I have sinned against you and I need you to have mercy upon me. I confess all of my sins. I am sorry for all the sins I've committed. I believe you died at Calvary for me. I believe you shed your precious blood for me. I believe your precious blood can wash away all my iniquities. So with my whole heart, I believe you, Lord Jesus. And with my mouth, I confess you as my Lord and my personal Savior. Wash me, Lord, and make me whole. Come, Lord Jesus, live in my heart. Be the Lord of my life. Fill me anew. Fill me today with your Holy Spirit. Make me a new creation. Make me a new creation. According to your promise in the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 5, verse 17, that if any man be in Christ, he's a new creation. So make me new, Lord Jesus. Make me new, Lord Jesus. Take away all my sinful pleasures. Take away my sinful desires. Take them away, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. I thank you for hearing me. I thank you for receiving me. I thank you for forgiving me in Jesus' name. I'm praying for you now. Lord, I thank you for the word that you gave unto me. I have delivered to the city of Greensboro, to the county of Guilford, to the state of North Carolina, to the nation of America, and to the world. Father, your word will never come back void. It will accomplish the purpose for which it has been sent. I pray that every heart upon which your word has landed, Father, may your word dissolve every stony heart, remove the stubborn hearts, and give everyone a new heart of flesh, according to your promise in the book of Ezekiel, chapter 36 and verse 26. O God, for you said, with that day we shall call upon you, and you will answer us, and you will sprinkle us with clean water. You will take our stony heart away and give us a new heart of flesh, and you will put your spirit in us, and will cause us to look upon our former life and hate with a perpetual hatred. Lord, take away the stony hearts. Lord, take away the stubborn heart and give us a new heart of flesh in the name of Jesus Christ. My Heavenly Father, I lift up the city of Greensboro, the state of North Carolina, the nation of America. I lift before you tonight. We are in a political climate, Father, to determine who is to lead this nation. You are the one who makes kings, and you are the one who dethrones kings. So, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we are praying that you move by the power of your Holy Spirit and direct your people to do that which is according to your perfect will. Father, give us the man or the woman after your own heart. You know the one after your heart, the one that will do righteousness, the one that will do holiness, the one that has the fear of God. Father, give us the man or the woman after your own heart, in the name of Jesus. This nation, my Father, has to come to know you, Jesus Christ. This nation, Father, has to move away from all wickedness. This nation, Father, has to move away from all iniquity. So, Father, give us the kind of leader who has your fear, who has your fear, who reverences you, who makes you first and foremost in everything. Father, give us that kind of leader in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, rise up. Arise in this nation. Let holiness, let righteousness, let justice, let truth, let honesty, let purity become the cornerstone, the foundation, principles, O God, of our politics, in the name of Jesus Christ. Glorify your holy name, O God. Father, glorify your holy name. Let your fear come upon the nation. Let your fear grip the hearts of leaders. Everyone from the White House all the way down to the street, let the fear of God grip the hearts of men and women everywhere in the name of Jesus, to bring many unto repentance, to bring many unto repentance, to bring many unto repentance from the White House, through the Congress, through the, yes, my Father, the Supreme Court, yes, Father, through the governor's mansions, through the mayoral offices, yea, my God, through the commissioner's offices, let the fear of God come upon every nooks and crooks of this nation in the name of Jesus Christ. Take control, Father. Father, take control over the nation in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind every spirit, every controlling spirit, demonic forces, principalities and powers, secret societies that operate at night, that control the spirit of this nation. Father, spirits that are, oh God, ready to shed blood, sacrificing blood, witches and wizards, we come against them with the fire from the divine presence, devour them and destroy them. Let your Holy Spirit and only your Holy Spirit, Father, let your Holy Spirit and only your Holy Spirit brood over the hearts of men and women in this nation, in the name of Jesus Christ. And let it begin, Father, in Greensboro. Let it begin in Greensboro. We come against the spirit of murder. We bind that spirit that works in our young men, that causes them to take weapons and kill indiscriminately. That spirit that is working in them, we bind that spirit in the name of Jesus. We curse the spirits. We curse them at the root in the name of Jesus. Deliver our young men. Deliver our leaders. Deliver them, my God. Cause our leaders to set a good example by resolving problems, oh God, through diplomacy, rather than, oh God, war. And yes, Father, yes, wanton destruction in the name of Jesus. Teach our leaders how to resolve matters. Yea, that they will resolve matters amicably through diplomacy. Through diplomacy. Through diplomacy. Because as we vent our spleens at the top, it trickles down to the very bottom, and our young ones also latch onto it, and they don't know how to talk to each other rather than, oh God, using violence to eliminate one another. Father, let our leaders set a good example. In the name of Jesus, glorify your holy name. Father, glorify your holy name. Let righteousness pour like rain. Let righteousness pour like rain. Let righteousness pour like rain upon this nation. In Jesus' name I have prayed. And with the saints of God, we shall all say, amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with each and every one of us, even now and forevermore. Amen. When my eyes behold the stars, this heart of mine is made to wonder. My poor soul cannot grasp their array. But the hands that spill them there, all around the wide heavens, must have known why he placed them that way. Known only to him are the great hidden secrets. I fear not the darkness where my flame shall be. I know not what the future holds, but I know who holds the future. It's a secret known only to him. I know not what the future holds, but I know who holds the future. It is a secret known only to him. Beloved, I don't know what the future holds, but I know who holds the future. Do you know who holds your future? That's the question I'm leaving with you tonight. Till next week, Friday, when you hear from us again, perhaps the Lord will prompt your heart to search for the right answer. And the only one who holds that future is Jesus Christ and him crucified. God bless you. God bless you. And I wish you all of God's grace as you go through the night. In Jesus' name. Amen. Now let me make this announcement quickly. On Sundays at 11 o'clock, we have a regular service. At 9:30, we have a school of discipleship and leadership. It is a 1-hour study of the Word of God where everybody has the opportunity to discuss. They read the scriptures, they expound it the way they understand it, and then we ask questions, just like you would do in your Sunday schools, but this is a little bit different because we study books. We take the book and take a chapter every week. And this time, on Sundays, we are in the Old Testament, and then on Wednesdays at 6:30, we come back and do the same, but this time in the New Testament. And we do that so that by the end of the year, we are able to cover the whole Bible and start again. So if it is something that will interest you, and you live in this Greensboro area, or maybe the adjoining cities, and you can drive away here, we are inviting you to come if you don't have a place of worship. This is All Nations Evangelical Church. So you are invited, whether you are Chinese. In fact, we need some more Chinese. We need some Koreans, we need some Mexicans, we need everybody. Come and be part of us if you don't have a place you call home. On 2nd November through the 6th of November, that is in 2 weeks' time, we'll be hosting Sonny Badu. Evangelist Sonny Badu. This man is blessed, endowed with the gift of worship. He is the Asaph. He's like the Asaph of our time. In the Old Testament, Asaph was the one to whom David will write songs and give to, and he will sing Jedutun, Asaph, and the Kohathites. They are the singers. And this young man comes from that realm, because when he sings, when he ministers, something happens to you. Well, by the grace of God, he is coming to All Nations Evangelical Church to hold a conference here called Worship. I want to invite you all to come, wherever you are. If you are watching us by YouTube, come. This is All Nations Evangelical Church. Our address is 2721 Ring Road, Greensboro, North Carolina. We are sandwiched between Walmart and Dollar Tree here on East Coast Boulevard. This neighborhood is called the Pyramid Center. So we invite you to come and join us November 2nd through November 6th. 5 days and six worship moments with Sonny Badu and his group. God bless you. God bless you. And we look forward to seeing you in Jesus' name. Amen.